morning, viewers. You are watching news with me, Ainun Alfi Aulia. We will bring you with the most updated news about the impact of coronavirus in Indonesia. The impact of coronavirus outbreak and coronavirus or COVID-19 to Indonesian economy is undeniable. In one particular occasion, Finance Minister Sri Mulyani Indrawati has said that Indonesia's economic growth adversely affected by the COVID-19 as it affected the global economic growth. The virus is predicted to negatively impact Indonesian economic and revising 0.3 to 0.6 percentage point of growth. At the export and import standpoint, the figures have shown a slight reduction in January if we compare to the same period last year. As from the investment perspective, based on the BKPM data, the investment realization in February level not yet shown any negative impact. Up to February data, the investment realization figures on the right track. COVID-19 pandemic in Indonesia has a major socio-economic impact in the health sector. The impact is multisectoral and will be seen in the long term, hitting the poor and vulnerable the most. Damage coverage is difficult to fully anticipate at this point. While the government is making effort to mitigate its impact, households, especially the poor and the most vulnerable, will be severely affected by this pandemic. Households headed by women and their children will be particularly affected. From education aspect, the number of seats is empty in the classrooms are not only a limitation on the number of students in face-to-face learning in this pandemic, but also due to a number of students not continuing school because they choose early egg marriage. In Mandailing, North Sumatra, the school was surprised when students no longer attending school. After being asked by their parents, the students in senior high school Wan Pajabungan, who did not attend school, was married. The incidence of students choosing to get married instead of continuing their education was almost found in Mandailing, North Sumatra, out of 3 per 10 students each school choose to get married. According to the school, students who choose to get married reasoned that could not join online learning for too long because of the internet limitation. On average, they are students who live in remote village. One of the most important aspects of battling COVID-19 is ensuring that people know which preventive measures should be practiced. From the survey, more men are using masks or sanitizer and more women are reducing gatherings with 10 people or more than at the beginning of the pandemic. Increased hand washing with soap remains the most commonly implemented personal sanitation practice, 35%, followed by sanitizer or mask use, 45% as of September 2021. Monitoring and assessing the socioeconomic impact of the pandemic on households is an important and necessary first step for the collection of data and evidence to help address this impact. Generally, adherence to social distancing guidelines is lagging. Adherence is even lower among young people, with only 13% of men under 49 practicing social distancing as of July 2021. With the infection curve of COVID-19 not showing any indication of lessening, Indonesia will remain in uncertain circumstances. This makes it all the more important to have real-time data to this end. GPLC will continue to monitor development in Indonesia. At the end, we say thank you very much for your nice attention. See you in the other opportunity.